And let's go now to René Marsh, because René, it's my understanding we actually have a photo of this individual at a Trump rally from 2017.
Right, Brooke. So we have been digging into Cesar Sayoc's background and coming across his social media and within our own video archives. You are looking, it's highlighted there. This is a February 2017 rally in Melbourne, Florida. And this was towards the end of the rally, the end of the event. You see the man holding a sign with the CNN's letters there. That is Cesar Sayoc, again, standing behind the press riser. So what was happening in front of him is that the reporters were going live from the rally, and there he was holding a CNN sucks sign back in Florida back in 2017. We have been going through his social media. We do know that obviously authorities have been going through his social media as well. His Twitter account, extremely political in nature. In going through many of his tweets, it is clear that he had his eyes on his targets before he even mailed those suspicious packages, because as you go through, there's essentially a tweet for almost every person who was targeted, from Cory Booker to the Clintons to the Obamas to CNN. He has a negative tweet about all of those people on his Twitter feed. In fact, the criminal complaint, which we're just going through now, it actually makes the point that as recently as October 24th, Cesar Sayoc posted a tweet that was critical of Soros. Why that's an interesting piece of information is that tweet actually happened after the suspicious package was recovered from Soros's home. So he had been clearly monitoring the events. And again, when you go through his social media, extremely political in nature. There are several tweets at Donald Trump as well, wishing Donald Trump happy birthday. So he was very active in that way on Twitter, Brooke.
René, thank you. With me now, Van Jones, the host of The Van Jones Show here on CNN. And when you, this is America?
Yeah. Well, first of all, I just want to say, and any chance I get a chance to say this, I want to say it. Thank goodness for the way that Jeff Sessions has handled this. You know, obviously, I have a lot of differences with Jeff Sessions, but this is one of those moments where he showed absolute professionalism, patriotism, nonpartisanship, and got after this. And I think the world needs to see that. I think we all need to see that. That at the end of the day, there's some, when Van Jones and Jeff Sessions are on the same page, something's happening, okay? So you have to understand that this is very, very destructive to democracy. You know, I thought it was so sad to see the man there holding the sign up, you know, CNN sucks, whatever he was saying. I think the president is not to be held responsible for anybody who does stuff like this. You can't control what your followers do.
Yeah.
But it can set certain people off. And we all need to be more responsible with our rhetoric. We don't know who's listening when we're blowing off this steam, saying, oh, you know, CNN sucks, CNN sucks. Well, somebody may take that seriously, and someone here could have been hurt. Not, you know, again, it's not the president's fault. There's a lot of hot rhetoric on all sides, but we need to start to tone this stuff down, rein it in, so that there's less room for people to feel that they have license to do this kind of thing.
On the rhetoric point, I want to play some of what the president said earlier today from this event at the White House when he was he had been briefed by intel officials. He knew that an arrest had happened. This was the president.
We must never allow political violence to take root in America. Cannot let it happen. And I'm committed to doing everything in my power as president to stop it.
You know, today, in my opinion, he said all the right things. But to your point about rhetoric, this is a man who has the biggest megaphone in this entire country. In the world. And there was a missed opportunity to say, America, we all, in this political environment, we all need to tone it down.
Yeah. No, I think that's right. And, you know, there's teleprompter Trump, and then there's Twitter Trump. They're not the same Trump all too often. But, you know, I love it when he goes off of teleprompter and says something from his heart that is actually good. It has happened. He's done that on criminal justice sometimes. But he could have done that a lot more on this time. And listen, and it's not over. I mean, we're going to have, you know, days and days more coverage. There's plenty of opportunity for him to clarify to his own supporters and to everybody else that this is not acceptable. and that he does not want this from his supporters. If you like me and you want me to be president, do not do this. And just let it be.
Your former boss at the White House, former President Barack Obama, he on the receiving end, they obviously intercepted this package, but he was one of the targets. He is speaking at an event in just a couple of minutes from now, hasn't said anything publicly yet. What do you want to hear from him?
Well, let's just be clear. President Obama has been under threat since he announced for president in 2007 or whenever it was. So he is, and the Secret Service and others said that he was threatened excessively even for a U.S. president. So he's used to this in some ways. I think that he has a credibility to step forward and say, listen, this is not the right way to go. His family's lived under these threats for a long time. It's not new to him, but it's new to the country to hear that this has gone as far as it's gone, to hear that somebody's actually made an explosive, they actually put it in the mail, that somebody someplace, and thank God some postal worker someplace stopped this thing and saved his family. He can speak about that, I think, but I think those of us listening to him have to remember, this is new to us. It's not new to the Obamas.